A very good afternoon to all of you children. Sorry. A very good morning to all of you children. In today's session, we are going to learn about prepositions. We have already learned about preposition in the previous sessions too. Let's have a short recap before we start, move on to the exercises in worksheet 22, 23, 24, and 25. Okay, so let's start. Okay. So let me ask you a few questions related to the topic. Ameya, can you tell me what is a preposition? Unmute it, Ameya. Children, I wanted all of you to please do listen very, very carefully. Okay, first we need to know what is a preposition is. So preposition is a vast topic, children. There are many words related to the topic. Okay. So, who's that talking in between? All of you, please remute it. Yes. Ameya, come on, tell me what is a preposition? Yes, Ameya. Ameya, come on, tell me what is a preposition? Who can give me the answer? Okay, Hannah, come on, tell me. What is a preposition?
Preposition is a word placed before a noun. A pronoun to show the riches for the present tense to the other parts of sentence.
Okay. So who can give me now? Yes, very good. So Hannah, then anybody else who can give me the answer? Who can tell me what is a preposition is? Yes, anybody else? No one? Children, prepositions are position words. What are prepositions are called? Position words. Okay? Prepositions are called as position words. It tells us where a person, a place, an animal or a thing is being placed. I told you a few examples when I took the last session. Okay, what did I tell you? You are placed. Where are you placed now? You are sitting on the chair. So all of the preposition used, okay, to tell us where your position is or where you are placed. So you are sitting on the chair. So preposition is a word which tells us where a person, a place or animal or a thing is being placed. So preposition is called as a position word. Is that clear to all of you? Prepositions are called position words. It tells us where a person, a place, an animal or a thing is being placed. And also it tells us the relation between the noun or the pronoun with the other part of the sentence. Is that clear to all of you? Now let's move on to the topic. So all of you, please do listen. Preposition. We are in the topic preposition. I wanted all of you to listen very, very carefully. Okay, so listen. As I've told you, we are in the topic prepositions. Okay? So we are in the chapter preposition, that is worksheet 22, 23, 24 and also 25. Okay, all these are related to the prepositions. We have many exercises to be done. So before we move on to the exercises, we need to know what is a preposition is. I told you prepositions are position words. What are they called, children? They're called as position words. Okay. So it tells us where a person, a place or an animal or a thing is being placed. Okay. It tells us where a person, a place or an animal or a thing is being placed. Okay. So I told you a preposition tells us where a preposition. I'm writing it for you. It's for you to understand. A preposition tells us where. Okay? Where a person, means example is you, a person, a place, an animal. An animal or a thing is placed. Is that clear? Okay, for example, you are sitting on the chair. So on is a preposition used to say where you are placed now. Is that clear? So you are in the room. In is a preposition used to tell you where you are now. Is that clear? Now books are on the table. So on is a preposition used to tell where are the books are being placed. Then it also tells us, preposition also shows. It also shows the relation. Relation between what? It also shows the relation. It also shows the relation of what, children? Relation of a noun. Of a noun or a pronoun. Can you hear me? Of a noun or a pronoun with the other parts of the sentence. With the other parts of the sentence. Is that clear to all of you? So this is all about preposition. Is that clear? So prepositions are position words. It tells us where a person, a place, or animal, or a thing is being placed. And it also shows the relation between, that's why we tell you prepositions are position word or placed before. It tells us the position or it shows the relation between a noun or a pronoun with the other parts of the sentence. Is that clear? For example, in is a preposition, on is a preposition. All these are prepositions. So all of you, please do listen. A preposition is a word that tells us where a person, a place, an animal, or a thing is. Okay? And it also shows a relation between a noun or a pronoun with the other words in a sentence or the other parts of a sentence. Is that clear to all of you? Is that clear? Now, have all of you understood what is a preposition is? Now, we'll move on to the different types of prepositions. All of you, please do listen. Okay, take a rough book in front of you. Keep a rough book in front of you, all of you. I'll be asking you questions. All of you, keep a book in front of you so that you can note down the important points. Okay, so prepositions are called as position words. It tells us nouns, place, direction, and the time. Okay? It tells us three things that it tells us the direction, place, direction, and the time. So there are three types of prepositions are there, namely preposition of place, preposition of direction, and preposition of time. Okay, so a preposition is broadly divided into three: preposition of place, preposition of direction, and preposition of time. In your workbook, only exercises are given. So we have learnt about preposition in the previous classes too, that is in grade 2. So we'll be learning a little of it and then we'll move on to the exercises. Otherwise, you will not understand which preposition to be used. Okay, so preposition of place. That is the first one. Okay? So prepositions are broadly divided into three. How many they are divided into, children? They're broadly divided into three. What is the first one? Preposition of place. Okay, so we are going to learn about preposition of place. Under the preposition of place, we are going to learn about, see a preposition, what is, if the slide has been displayed, children, I wanted all of you to read what is written there. So a preposition of place, what does it show us? It shows us the position or the location of a noun or a pronoun. So preposition of place, what does it show us? Preposition of place, it shows us the position or the location of a noun or a pronoun. Please do learn it. So prepositions are broadly divided into three. They are the preposition of place, direction, time. So we are going to learn the first one, the preposition of place. What does it show us? Come on, tell me, what does it show us? It shows two things. What are they? Come on, I'll keep it unmuted for you all. Come on, tell position. Me. Answer. Position and?
Position and location.
Yes, position and the location. Position and the location of a noun or a pronoun. What do you mean by position? Position means what? Position means now we are the position of certain things. Okay, in, on, where are the books? On the table. Where is a cat? Under the table. So these are the position which I've already showed, slide related to the topic, under, over, okay, above, beside, near, all these are the, it tells us the position of a noun or a pronoun. Is that clear? Didn't we learn in the last session about the position of certain things? Didn't we? Put a thumbs up. Okay, didn't we learn about certain position of certain things? That is in, on, under, over, across. Then we have learned about between, between, among. Then we have learned about near, beside. So these are the prepositions which tells us the position of a noun or a pronoun. So in today's class, let's learn about the location. Location, I told you where it has been located. So we are talking about the place. Where is Thrissur is located? Where is Thrissur is located? It is located in Kerala. Okay, where is Kerala is in? Kerala is in India. Okay,
India.
Moving on to the proposal, under the preposition of place, position we have already learned. Now we are moving on to the location of a noun or a pronoun. So let's move on to it. Okay, all of you, please do listen. Unless you listen, children, this preposition is a very vast topic where it's not like conjunction. We have lots of words to learn about. Okay, but we learn certain words related to the topic. So I've told you, under the preposition of place, it shows the position and also the location of a noun or a pronoun. So under the position, we learned about these words. All these tells us about the position of a noun or a pronoun. That is in the bag, on the table, above, under, over, among, near, near, behind, beside. All these are the prepositions which tells us the position of a noun or a pronoun. Now we have learnt all these positions. Now we have learnt in the last session. Now we'll move on to the preposition of place, which tells us about the location. Under the location, we are going to learn about in and at. What are we going to learn? In. According to the position, in means in the bag. But according to the location, in, it tells us or it is used for countries, cities and towns. Is that clear the difference? Have you understood? According to the position, in means in the bag or in the pocket. Means something which is enclosed, we keep it in the box, in the pouch. Where do we keep the money? In the wallet or in the purse. Okay, means we keep it inside. So here in means, according to the location, in means it is used for countries, cities and towns. Please make a note of it. Okay, just now I'll be sending you the notes. All these are clearly given in your English grammar book grade 2. So these notes I will not send for you. Why? Means these are, we have already learned. If I send you the notes, it'll be too much for you. So in means, it is also used for countries, cities and towns. Lant? So he lives in Australia. He was born in India. So when we talk about countries, cities and towns, we use the preposition in. Clear? So when we talk about a definite or a specific place, we use the preposition at. When we talk about the preposition of place related to the location of an area of a noun or a pronoun, we have learned about in and at. So in and at, in means when we talk about the country, cities, and towns, and at is used to indicate a certain point. That means definite place or a definite place or a specific place. So the meeting was at the office. All these are clearly given in your grade 2 English grammar workbook. Please go through it. Okay, children, you have learned it last year. It is clear all these exercises are there in your workbook. Fill in the blanks using at or in. So I'll be calling certain children to answer these questions. Now, Advait Sibinal, come on. Do the first one for me.
Ma'am,
yes. It is not there in your workbook, my dear children. Please look at the slide and answer to my questions. Yes, do the first one.
Sneha Khan lives.
Shahrukh Khan lives. Shahrukh Khan lives.
Dance Mumbai. In Mumbai.
Shahrukh Khan lives.
In Mumbai.
Very good. In Mumbai. Shahrukh Khan lives in Mumbai. Okay. Shahrukh Khan lives in Mumbai. Very good. Mumbai is a city. So we have to use the preposition in. Okay. Now, Abhinav Krishna, come on, Abhinav. This is just a recapping session so that we have to know how to use. Yeah. Yes. Come on, Abhinav. Do the second one.
He was born dash India.
Okay. So?
In India.
Okay, in India. Then, Adiga, come on, Adiga.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, come on, tell me.
My mother is not dash home.
Okay, so?
At.
At, very good. At home. Why means here we are talking about a specific place, so we have to use there. At, Abel. Come on, Abel.
I away dash the.
I arrived dash the station on time. So, it is, we are talking about a definite place, a station. So which preposition we have to use? In is used with country, cities, and towns. And at, we speak about a definite place. So which one we have to use here? I arrived. Yes, come on, tell me the answer. Who's telling the answer here? Yes. Yes, children. Who knows the answer here? Yes, Naila, come on, tell me.
At,
yes, at the station. So I hope the position of place is over. We have learned about the position and also the location. So under the position, we have learned certain words, and under the location, it is in and at. Okay, is that clear to all of you? I hope so. Now we move on to the second type of preposition. That is, it is not given in your book as it is different types of preposition. So when we learn as such, we learn it as different types. Only then I can categorize the preposition into such. Okay. So here it is preposition of time. Preposition of time tells us when an event occurs. So under that, we will learn again three prepositions. That is in, on, and at. Okay. Can you listen? In, on, and at. In, on, and at. On is a preposition used for dates and days. Dates and days. Is that clear? On is a preposition used with dates and days. So I have a meeting on 2nd October. Is that clear? On 22nd October. That is 10th February 2021 is the date. Okay. 10th Feb 2021 is the date. So with dates, we use the preposition on. And also with days, we use the preposition on. Is that clear? Is that clear to all of you? So we are learning about preposition of. All of you, please do listen. So now preposition of place is over. Now we are moving on to preposition of time. Okay. So under the preposition of time, all of you please do look here. Preposition of time. What we have to do, we are going to learn about, it tells us when an event occurs. First is on. Okay. Then is in and it is at. Okay. So all of you please make a note of it. On. It is clearly given in your English grammar workbook in grade 2, children. Please make a note of it. On. It is used for days and dates. Can you remember all these, what you have learned? In is used with months, seasons, okay, year, and parts of the day. I'll show you the slide. Parts of the day. Okay, and at, when we talk about a specific. Similarly, like at, place. At, when we speak about a specific or a definite place. Similarly, when we talk about the time, when we talk about a definite time, we use the specific or a definite time, we use the preposition at. Okay, so a session started at 10:15 a.m. means sharp, sharp time. So when we talk about a sharp time, we use the preposition at. So this is all about the preposition of time. Okay, direction is a little bit vast topic. So preposition of place and preposition of time is quite easy to understand. So on, it is day and dates. In, it is month, season, year, and parts of the day. And at, we use for specific and definite time. Is that clear? Now let us move on to the slide. So in, it is used with months, season, year, and parts of the day. So Ron was born in 2024. Okay. I will go hiking in December. Children, if you have your grade 2 English grammar workbook, please take it and go through it so that you may understand. Okay. So at always indicate an exact or a specific time. We use the preposition at. Okay. And with all these expressions, that is the parts of the day, in the morning, in the afternoon, in the evening, in 5 minutes, in 6 days, in a week, in 2 years. For all these expressions, we use in the morning. That's why I told you parts of the day, but not all the parts of the day. I'll tell you, morning, afternoon, evening, we use in. Is that clear? Morning, afternoon, and evening, we use in preposition. And also we use in 5 minutes. I'll come within 5 minutes. Okay. In 6 days. Okay. In a week, in 2 years. So all these minutes, days, week, and years, we use preposition in. Okay. So please remember all this. Then we'll move on to at. So when we talk about noon, night, and midnight, we use the preposition at. So just remember all this. In the morning, in the afternoon, in the evening, in 5 minutes, in 6 days, in 2 hours, okay, in 2 years, all these we use in. But at is used when we talk about at noon, at night, and at midnight. Okay, at noon, at night, and at midnight. Clear? All these are very clear. If it's clear, let's move on to an exercise. Okay, then after doing this exercise is there in your English grammar workbook, grade 2. Okay, after doing this exercise, then we'll move on to the exercise which is there in our workbook. Okay, are you all ready? Andrea, come on. Do the first one for me. Just read it, 6th July. So which preposition you will use? Is it at, in, or on?
Ma'am,
come on. What is that?
I am done now only.
What is it? I couldn't understand. I couldn't understand what you're saying. Okay, Iron, come on.
That's 6th July.
What happened, children? Was there any problem?
No.
Then, what has happened? Okay, we'll do that exercise. Are you all ready?
Yes.
Okay, come on, do it. Anna is not there. Anna Rose, come on, do that. It is 6th of July. So what do you will do there?
At 6th of July.
6th of July, it is a date. Okay, 6th of July. What is today's date? It's 10th Feb. Okay, 2021. Similarly, 6th of July is a date. So with date, which preposition do we use?
At.
At means when we talk about a specific or a definite place or a time, we use at. Okay, this is a date. So this is a date. So which preposition do we use with preposition when we talk about the days and the dates?
In. On.
On, very good. So we use on with both the D's, dates and days. Is that clear? Then, Gauri Nanda, come on, do the next one. Quickly do it. We have hardly 2 minutes more. Come on. Okay, Raika, then do it. Yes, do it. Do the next one. Quickly, children. Are you able to unmute it? Yes, that you do it. See, your children, on is used with day and dates. In is used with periods of time in the sense, and is used with year, seasons, months, and period of the day. And at is used when we talk about a specific or a definite time. So here it is 10:30. So what do you use, Raika? Raika, you're not able to? No? Then what? Then come on, speak.
At 10:30 a.m.
Yes, we'll do it. It's, we are running out of time. It is a year, 1992. So which one we will use? I will unmute you all. So what we will use? It is a year. So which preposition do we use there?
In.
8 o'clock. So what do we use there?
At.
It is day. So what do we use there? Day.
March.
It is a month. So what do we use?
In.
Winter season. So what do we use?
In.
Evening means which preposition do we use?
In five minutes.
Yes. So all of you,
time is up.
Please go through the English grammar workbook of grade 2. Then we'll finally we do this exercise. Okay. So once we learn about all the prepositions as such, move on to the exercise there in our English grammar workbook. Okay, children. So it's time for us to wind up today's session. Bye.
Bye.
Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye.